good afternoon on Friday the 23rd of September, and I do hope that this week has worked out for you. Our opening prayer. As our evening prayer rises before you, O God, so may your mercy come down upon us to cleanse our hearts and set us free to sing your praise now and forever. Amen. Today's readings are from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 11, and Zechariah chapter 8, verses 9 to 23. We might not have recognized it as we lived through it, but the past 5 or 6 years will be seen as a pivotal time in our nation's history. To the backdrop of a global pandemic, we've left the EU, had 4 prime ministers, and our monarch for 70 years has died. Now, it's rather unusual for a passage of scripture to become the words for a piece of popular music, but today's reading from Ecclesiastes on the theme of a time for everything is mainly known because of the song composed around the words. The message is an enduring one. Life is full of fluctuating fortunes, yet God is able to sort things out. Something which, despite their best efforts, humans are unable to do. In a few years' time, with the benefit of hindsight, we'll be able to see more clearly about how the timing of these events that I've mentioned has worked out. Yesterday, we left the people in Zechariah's time not knowing how God will work out the promise that he's given to them. We learn a bit more today about this outworking. More reassurance is given to them because those people are very low in trust and confidence. Don't give up or be afraid or lose courage, says the Lord. He assures the people that he'll do his bit to sort things out, but the people also need to play their part. The onus isn't on God alone. The particular areas identified by God as those which the people need to address to ensure that they do progress are that they need to be very careful with the truth. They should stop plotting against each other and being devious. And, importantly, they should ensure that they seek godly peace at all times. And that leads us into our next prayer. Almighty God, from whom all thoughts of truth and peace come, we ask that you stir in our hearts the true love of peace, and that you guide the leaders of the nations with your peaceable wisdom until the earth is filled with the knowledge of your love. Amen. We come to our prayer points, and earlier today we heard the government's autumn statement or mini budget, and our prayer points link to this. Firstly, let's pray for those businesses struggling to keep their prices down whilst having to pay increased overheads. Then pray for all struggling to balance their household budgets with rising costs for energy, food and fuel. And importantly, let's give thanks for all organisations who are seeking to relieve suffering. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Don't forget that tomorrow St. Aidan's Church is open between 10 in the morning and 2 in the afternoon for coffee and cake. And if you want to view the church history, tying in to our 90th anniversary. And a blessing. The glory of the Father, the peace of the Saviour, the power of the Holy Spirit be within you and about you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and your loved ones today